When I was listening to you, I was actually starting to feel guilty. You know, this panel, we don't have the parity on this panel. And I think we need to walk the talk more often. So thank you very much. Eric, may I invite you to share with us also your views on this issue of inclusive growth and jobs?
Good morning. Thank you so much for being given this opportunity to be able to talk about the challenges of the youth that we face on entrepreneurship. And as I came in, I realized most of the people don't tweet and they don't use social media. Myself, I use social media so much in terms of mentoring the youth and voicing the challenges. And I asked the youth, what are the challenges that they face mostly in entrepreneurship in Kenya? Most of them said, the key challenge that they said was funds, capital to start businesses. One of the biggest challenges in Kenya. First of all, as a young person, you are asked if you have, the access to that capital is very hard. When you go to the banks, you ask for a title deed, or if you have a title deed, they ask for developed property, which is a big challenge. A 30-year-old, a 29-year-old, or a 22-year-old will not be having that, that developed property. And another challenge that came out clearly was access to information. Most of the youth, they have their ideas, but they don't have that access to information, like where to start, what are the requirements for registration, what is the legal framework. And with that, you find that most of the youth are unemployed, or they have that an idea, but they don't have that where to start. So we need that private and public partnership to be able to sensitize the public on entrepreneurship, because entrepreneurship is very important on our Kenyan government, or the development of the Kenyan government, whereby if we encourage entrepreneurship. My personal experience is that I've been able to employ eight youth in my company, which if we are able to nurture, sensitize, and put a lot of effort on entrepreneurship, we'll be able to tackle now the current issue of security, other social issues like crime, addiction to drugs. So I really recommend the government to put a lot of effort encouraging and nurturing the youth in terms of entrepreneurship. Another challenge that we face is infrastructure. Currently I'm doing it's a World Bank donor funded project. I've been going all over the country installing these tents in all hospitals in Kenya, all the 47 counties. But what came clearly, the infrastructure, as my distinguished panelist, Mr. Mungo Kibati, said, from Taveta or you go to Hola, the road infrastructure, the road network is very bad. And I had to sleep on the forest. It was it was a nasty experience. If the government can work on that, we'll be able to have good information, and we'll be able to practice entrepreneurship very well. Another thing, there's this culture of, as Kenyans, we have a culture that is not good, that does not give a conducive environment for business, whereby for you, as much as they have given 30% provision for tendering procurement, government tendering procurement process, we'll find out there is a lot of corruption. Corruption is one of the biggest impediments, nepotism and tribalism, whereby we'll find out that I have to know someone who knows another person for me to be able to get a contract. You will not get a contract out of the merit. You'll get a contract because of who you know. And that's most of the contacts that we get as young entrepreneurs. We get from, we call them tenderpreneurs. Tenderpreneurs are people who, they know someone who knows another person to get that contract. And that's a challenge, because sometimes you feel discouraged as a youth entrepreneur. You have done, you have put the structures in your company, but someone else, we call them brokers or entrepreneurs, will come and give you that contract, subcontract you, and you have the capability and the capacity. Another challenge was political change. In 2013, myself, I had a nice experience. I was almost closing shops, because each after every 5 years, we have like to restart again. It's like we're restarting the business again, and it's a very it's a challenge, because maybe you'll have to start some employees. You have to cut costs in terms of cost of operation, and it's very hard in terms of the each election year. If the government can check on that, we have that culture of trust and give us an enabling political environment for us to be able to work on. Another challenge that came in was our education system. Our education system, right from the 844 system, does not encourage or create innovation or entrepreneurship. In Kenya, you learn to get a job, not to learn to create a job. And if they are able to put more syllabus on entrepreneurship, we'll be able to tackle a lot of issues that we are facing currently in Africa. And we need to, like the World Bank and the government, let's have like a mentorship program. There are many people who have that capability and capacity, that we may be able to educate them and start encourage mostly to put more effort on it, on entrepreneurship. It's not a must you go to university to be able to work. You have a university degree to be able to do entrepreneurship. So if you are able to come up with systems and structures that youth entrepreneurs will be able to be nurtured and cultivated well, we are able to go well. Another thing, as much as I said, capital is an impediment to do entrepreneurship, we need to have that culture change about, as much as you have a capital, to me, an idea is a capital in itself. Determination is a capital in itself. So if people are, I'm really focusing so much on effort to sensitize the entrepreneurs that it's not all about capital. They have to start with what they have. Think small, start big, and start now. With that, thank you so much.
Back here 15 minutes earlier. On your way out of the tent, please pick up one of those voucher cards. You need that for lunch. They will be handed out right outside the tent. This green voucher card you need for lunch. Lunch will be in the main meeting, I mean the main hotel lobby. But please, we have ladies who will escort you through the side entrance. Otherwise, you have to go to the main security of the lobby. So we can usher you in through the side door. Find them, they will show you the way.